Hello? Where are you? Don't be afraid. Oh, there you are. I have been looking all over for you, little one. You had me so worried. But now you are here, and it is time for a story. So please, get comfortable and listen. Let's begin, shall we? There was once a girl named Cinderella who lived with her wicked stepmother and two stepsisters. They made poor Cinderella do all their chores, as they did not have the luxury of a General Atomics International Miss Nanny to do chores for them. One day, the family received an invitation to the Prince's Royal Ball. Everyone was excited, especially Cinderella. She asked if she could go too. However, her stepmother and stepsisters just laughed. Of course not, silly Cinderella, her older stepsister said. You would just embarrass us. Her younger stepsister scowled and said, you're full of dirt and you don't even have a dress. So, instead of going to the ball, Cinderella was forced to stay home and clean the floors. Oh, how she wished she could go. Then she heard a kindly old woman's voice. It's me, your fairy godmother. I heard your wish, and I will help you go to the ball. The fairy godmother waved her wand, and a beautiful dress appeared around Cinderella, along with two glass slippers on her feet. She waved her wand at a pumpkin, which turned into a silver carriage, and a family of mice, which turned into a team of horses to pull the carriage. The fairy godmother warned her, you must be home by midnight. Cinderella thanked the fairy godmother and sped off towards the ball. When she arrived, she was awestruck. She had never seen anything like it. Soon enough, the prince himself asked her to dance. All eyes were on Cinderella. But her stepmother and stepsisters did not even recognize her. They were jealous of the girl dancing with the prince. The clock struck midnight, and it was time for Cinderella to go before the magic wore off. She ran off and dropped the slipper as she hurried. The prince searched the kingdom for the girl he had danced with that night. Eventually, he came to Cinderella's home with the slipper. The slipper did not fit any of the women until Cinderella asked to try it on. Her mother and sisters laughed, but to their surprise, it fit! They married and lived happily ever after in a giant castle with every General Atomics International robot, the prince's vast fortune could buy.